Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to improve our math skill. Today is our lesson number 19. Yesterday, and if you have not watched yesterday's video already, it is imperative, it is crucial, it is vital, it is essential that you stop this video right now. Watch the yesterday's video, day number 18, because what we're going to deal with today builds upon what we did yesterday. Yesterday we talked about what prime numbers are conceptually, what characteristics do they possess, what makes a number a prime number, what makes a number not a prime number. Today we will not go into all of that. All we're going to do today is to list the prime numbers 1 through 50. Alright? So let's begin. At any time, if you feel that you are having some trouble understanding, or if you feel that I'm brushing something off, I assure you it is because we already talked about it, we already covered it in yesterday's video, day number 18. Yesterday's video, day number 18, was almost 20 minutes long, and we discussed in detail, thoroughly, what makes something a prime number and what makes something not a prime number, as I said already. 1 through 50 is what we're dealing with. In order for a number to be a prime number, first of all, it has to be an odd number. No even number can be a prime number. So let's list all the odd numbers 1 through 10. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. First thing first, what we learned yesterday is that 1 is not a prime number. Why is 1 not a prime number? Because what we learned yesterday is that prime numbers are numbers that have exactly two factors. Prime numbers are numbers that have exactly two factors. 1 and the number itself. 2 meets those two conditions. Not those two conditions, rather. 2 meets that condition. It meets that condition because 2 has only two factors, 1 and 2. The only way we can divide 2 evenly into, the only number that we can divide 2 by, is by 1 and itself. And that is the definition of a prime number. A prime number is one that can be divided only by itself and 1. 2 can only be divided by itself and 1. And therefore 2 qualifies as a prime number even though it's an even number. It is the only even number that is a prime number. No other even number will qualify as a prime number, which is why we did not list all the even numbers. We only listed all the odd numbers. So 2, even though it's an even number, 2 is the only even number that is prime number. Now, how do we recognize if a given number is a prime number or not? It's very simple. This is what we need to do. In the beginning, of course, we don't have to do any of this thing because these numbers are too small, it'll be too silly, but we want to learn the process. Is 3 a prime number? We ask ourselves, can we divide 3 by any of the previous prime numbers? Well, the only prime number, 1 is not a prime number, the only prime number that comes before 3 is 2. And obviously, 3 divided by 2 is not an integer. 3 cannot be evenly divided by 2. Therefore, 3 qualifies as a prime number. Can we divide 5? Can we divide 5 by any of the previous 2 prime numbers? The answer is no. We're not going to keep talking about 2 because it'll be silly to ask ourselves, can we divide it by 2? Obviously, we can't divide it by 2 because we're only listing the odd numbers. So the only other prime number that appears before 5 is 3. And of course, we can't divide 5 by 3 because if we were to divide 5 by 3, it is not going to be an integer. Therefore, 5 is also a prime number. 7 is a prime number because 7 cannot be divided by 3. It is not an integer. If you were to do that, 7 divided by 5 is not an integer. Therefore, it's an even number. What about 9? 9 is not a prime number because we can divide 9 by one of the previous prime number. We can divide it by 7, we can divide it by 5, but we can divide it by 3, which is why 9 is not a prime number. Let's pick up speed now. Which is why 9 is not. But that's what we have to do. 11, 13, 15, 17, and 19. As the numbers get larger, this is what we have to do in order to ask, in order to realize whether a given number is a prime number or not. 11 is not a prime number. Why is it not a prime number? I'm going to go a little bit faster now. We're not going to worry about 2 anymore, because none of these numbers can be divided by 2, because none of them are even numbers. 11 is not a prime. 11 is a prime number because you can divide it by 3. 11 cannot be divided evenly by 5. You cannot divide 11 by 7. And that's it. 9 is not a prime number. So 11 qualifies. 13 is a prime number because we can't divide 13 by 3. We can't divide 13 by 5. We can't divide 13 by 7. And we cannot divide 13 evenly by 11. It is a prime number. What about 15? 15, can we divide it by 3? The answer is yes, 15 can be divided by 3. The fact that it can also be divided by 5 is a moot point. We only have to be able to find one prime number that we can divide this number by, and we're done. Prime numbers are the building blocks. Prime numbers are the building blocks. Think of prime numbers as atoms in chemistry. Everything else, all the other countings, all the other numbers are composite numbers. They are made up of prime numbers. If you look at 10, 10 is a composite number because it is made up of two prime numbers. If you look at 16, 16 is a composite number because it is made up of prime number, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. If you look at 6, 6 is made up of 2 and 3. All the other numbers are made up of prime numbers. All the other numbers are built upon the prime numbers. Prime numbers are the building blocks. That's why we have to check, in order to make sure that the number is not a prime number, we have to make sure that it is not divisible by any of the previous prime numbers. 15 is divisible by 3, therefore it is not a prime number. 17 is a prime number because we can't divide 17 by 13. It's not going to divide evenly. We can't divide 13 by 11. Of course, we could divide 17 by 11. We can divide 17 by any number. But what we mean when we say we cannot divide, what we mean is that we cannot divide evenly. We cannot divide 17 evenly by 7. 17 divided by 5 is not going to be an integer. 17 divided by 3 is not going to be an integer. 17 is a prime number, and so is 19. Let's carry on. 21, 23, 25, 27, and 29. 29 can be divided by 3? It can be divided by 3? How do we know whether or not we can divide 21 by 3? It's a very silly question. It's a silly question because it's a very small number. But I want you to get in the habit of doing this thing, because this habit will come in quite handy when we're dealing with the large numbers. How do we know if 21 is divisible by 3? Well, here's the answer. I'm going to put it here. Oh, we shouldn't have erased this thing. Let's list the prime numbers one more time. 2, 3, 5, and 7. A number, if the sum of the digits, if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the number itself is divisible by 3. If the sum, S-U-M, sum of the digits, if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the number itself is divisible by 3. 21, if you take the sum of the digits of 21, 21 is 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1, the sum of the digits is 3, and of course 3 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 21 is divisible by 3, which was a silly thing to do, because 21 is such a small number. We know right away that 21 is simply 3 times 7. And because it is made up of two prime numbers, or it is divisible by at least one prime number, 21 is not a prime number. 23 is a prime number because we cannot divide 23 by 3. We're not going to check 2 anymore because these are not even numbers. 23 cannot be divided by 3 evenly. 23 cannot be divided by 5. We cannot divide 23 by 7. If you were to divide 23 by 7, we'll end up with 23 divided by 7. With 21. 21 has 3 sevens, so we're going to end up with 3, and the remainder of 2 is going to end up with 3 and 2 sevens. It's not going to be a whole number. 23 cannot be divided by 11 because 11 times 2 is 22. We're going to have a remainder of 1. We cannot divide 23 by 13 because we're going to have a remainder. 23 is a prime number. But you only have to hit the halfway mark. You don't have to keep on going forever. You only have to hit the halfway mark. This was the halfway mark, because 23 times 2 is 26. Which means if you were to divide 23 by 13, we'll have a remainder of 10. And after we divide, if you divide 23 by 17, you're going to have some remainders there. You only have to hit the halfway mark. 25 is not a prime number because we cannot divide 25 by 3, but we can divide 25 by 5. 25 is 5 times 5. So it's not a prime number. Neither is 27. How do we know that 27 is not a prime number? Because 2 plus 7 is 9, and the sum of the digits is 9. Since 9 is divisible by 3, therefore the number itself is divisible by 3, which of course we know. Of course we know that it is simply 3 times 9, or 3 times 3 times 3. 3 times 3 times 3. As you can see, it does not need to be divisible by two prime numbers. As long as we can divide a given number by at least one prime number, then the number itself is not a prime number. 27 can be divided by 3. And that's all we need. Therefore, 27 is not a prime number. 29 is a prime number because 29 is a prime number because we can't divide 29 by 3. 29 will not divide evenly by 5. 29 will not divide by 7 because if we were to divide by 7, we'll have 28, which is 4 sevens, and then we're going to have a remainder of 1. As you can see, 29 cannot be divided by 7 evenly. 29 is not divisible by 11 because either you'll have 33 or 22. You cannot divide it by 13 because 13 times 2 is 26. We're going to have a remainder of 2. We can't divide it by 17. We're going to have a remainder. Therefore, it is a prime number. It is a prime number. Let's circle our prime numbers that we have so far. So all of these are prime numbers. Then we have 11, 13, 17, 19, 27 is not a prime number. Let's continue. So we were up to 30, 31, 33, 35, 37, and 39. This is where the habit that we just developed, the habit that I was talking about, which is to check. You always make sure, you always check to see if a given number is divisible by any of the previous prime numbers, such as 37. When the numbers get larger, that habit comes in quite handy. Do you understand? So 31. Can we divide 31 by 3? The answer is no. 31 is not divisible by 3. It is not divisible by 5. It is not divisible by 7. It is not divisible by 11. It is not divisible by 13. 13 times 2 is 26. We're going to have a remainder with 31. It is not divisible by 17. It is not divisible by 19. It is not divisible by 23. Well, we have to just hit halfway mark. Halfway mark for 31 is 15. We can stop right here between 13 and 17. Then we have 25, 27, and 29. How about 33? 33, can it be divided by 3? Answer is yes, of course. 33 is simply 3 times 11. So it is not a prime number. Can we divide 35 by 3? Can we divide 35 by 3? The answer is no. 35 by 3, 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 is not divisible by 3, so 35 is not divisible by 3. Can we divide it by 5? Answer, of course, is yes. If it ends in a 5 or a 0, if a number ends in a 5 or a 0, it's divisible by 5. It is not a prime number because it's simply 5 times 7. How about 37? Let's slow down, take our time. 37. Remember, we only have to hit the halfway mark. After that, you're going to have a remainder. 37, 38, around 18, 19, we can stop. Can we divide 37 by 3? The answer is no. We're going to have 36 and a remainder of 1. Okay, we cannot divide it by 5 because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. We certainly cannot divide it by 7 because 7 5s are 35. If we were to divide by 7, 7 5s are 35, we're going to have a remainder of 2. That's no good. That's no bloody good. Can we divide it by 11? The answer is no. There'll be 33. If we were to divide by 11, we'll have 33, which is 3 times, and we'll have a remainder of 4. 4 11th. It's not divisible by 13. It's not divisible by 13 because 13 times 2 is 26. 13 times 6 is 26. We're going to have a remainder of 9. It's not divisible by 17 because 17 times 2 is 34. We're going to have a remainder of 3. And 19 is going to go above it. 19 times 2 is 38. 37, it turns out, is the prime number. What about 39? 39, we can clearly see 39 is divisible by 3 because if you divide 39 by 3, 3 has 1 3 in it and 9 has 3 3s in it. 39 divided by 3 is 13, which means 39 is simply 3 times 13. 39 is the product of two prime numbers. 39 is not a prime number. It's a composite number. Let's do the next 10. 41 through 50. 41 through 50. The word I've been using is this. composite number. 39, we just found out, was 3 times 13. It is a composite number, it's not a prime number. It is made up of two prime numbers. 41, 43, 45, 47, and 49. This is where we have to slow down. Remember, it's 41, which means we have to hit the halfway mark. We have to go at least up to 20, or maybe, but there is no 21. 21 is not a prime number, so we have to go all the way up to 19 or 23. 23 times 2 is 23 times 2 is 46. That's above it. 19 times 2 is 38. So if you were to divide 41, if you were to divide 41 by 2, that's 38, and then we'll have a remainder of 3. We'll have a remainder of, no, what am I doing here? If we were to divide 41 by 19, 19 times 2 is 38. 19 times 2 is 38. We'll have a remainder of 3. As you can see, 41 is not divisible by 19. 41 is not divisible by 34. 41 is not divisible by 34 because 34 times 2 is 17 times 2 is 34. We can have a remainder. It is not divisible by 13 because 13 times 3 is 39. 13 times 3 is 39. We'll have a remainder of 3. It's not divisible by 11 because we don't have 33. For it to be divisible by 11, we need either a 33 or a 44. It's not divisible by 7. It's not divisible by 7 because 7 fives are 35. 7 fives are 35. We have a 41. We'll have a 6 remainder. It's not divisible by evenly. It's not divisible by 5 clearly because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. It's not divisible by 3 because 4 plus 1 is 5 and 5 is not divisible by 3. So 41 is a prime number. How about 43? Well, you get the idea now. I'm not going to keep doing it. 43 is a prime number. 45 is not a prime number because it's simply 5 times 9. It is divisible by 5. It is not a prime number. What about 47? For 47, we have to go around in 23 and 29 is where we have to stop. 47, let's do it. 4 plus 7 is, always check to make sure the number is not divisible by 3. Because that's the one people miss most often. 4 plus 7 is 11. 11, sum of the digits is 11. 11 is not divisible by 3, therefore 47 is not divisible by 3. Is it divisible by 5? The answer is no, it's not divisible by 5 because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. Is it divisible by 7? Is it divisible by 7? Now 7 is a tricky one. You actually really have to do it out. That's the only way you can tell whether a number is divisible by 7 or not. Don't be hasty, otherwise you're going to end up making a mistake. Do you understand? You have to do it out. Do you understand? For example, the classic number that most people end up missing when they're talking about... I'm going to digress here for a second. Digress. Of course, we learned the word digress in our vocabulary lesson, which means to change a topic. I'm going to stop right now what we're talking about. I'm going to change the topic just for a second. Vocabulary, day 3. Digress is a word that we learned in our vocabulary lesson in day number 3. If you're interested in learning it, just type in vocabulary words, GRE vocabulary words, or SAT vocabulary words, or SAT vocabulary words, day 3, and you will learn the word digress, which means to change the topic. For example, the one that people miss most very often when they're talking about prime numbers, when you ask them to make a list of prime numbers, the one that they miss very often is, do you know which one it is? The very common mistake, the one that people miss very often is 91. Now, do you know why people miss it? It's because they don't take their time to check each one of them individually. You don't have to check for 2. You don't have to check for 2 because there is no point in having an even number. Even number is not a prime number. You have to start with 3. But you have to go slowly and you have to take it slowly and check every one of them. Every one of them. 91. Is it divisible by 3? 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 is not divisible by 3 since the sum of the digits is not divisible by 3. 91 is not divisible by 3. Of course, we knew that because 90 is divisible by 3. And 93 is divisible by 3. 91 is not. How about 5? Is it divisible by 5? The answer is no, it is not divisible by 5. It's not divisible by 5 because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. For a number to be divisible by 5, the last digit needs to be either a 5 or a 0. Is it divisible by 7? That's where you have to take your time. That's where you have to slow down and take your time to make sure you don't miss it. Can we divide 97, 91 by 7. The question is, how are we going to go about doing it? The answer is, just by doing it. Like this, the grown-up method, not the long division, not the long division, the grown-up method, not the baby method, the grown-up method. How many 7 in a 9? How many 7 in a 9? How many 7 in a 9? 9 has 1 7. 9 has 1 7. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 2. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1 becomes 21. And how many 7 in a 21? 21 has 3 7. Voila! We just found out that 91 is actually 7 times 13. Now, if you don't like what I just did here, I can actually show you the long division and show you that the process is the same as a long division. Let's do. We don't need any of this thing now. Let's erase all of this. Let's do the long division here. 91 divided by 7. And watch what happens. We're going to do the same exact process. We're going to do the same exact process simultaneously. 91 divided by 7. We're going to do the exact same process here and here. So you can compare the two side by side in a juxtaposition. How many 7 does 9 have? 9 has 1 7. How many 7 does 9 have? 9 has 1 7. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1. And becomes 21. How many 7 does 21 have? The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1, becomes 21, and 21 has 3 7s. But as you can see, this method is very time consuming. This is a faster method, much faster method. Do you understand? Anyway, so 91 is not a prime number. Back to our list. 41, 43, 45, 47, and 49. 41 is a prime number, 43 is a prime number, 45 is not, 47 is a prime number, and 49 is not an odd. 49 is not, because 49 is divisible by 7, because 49 is a perfect square, is 7 times 7. 7 times 7. Just give me one brief second. I just want to make sure that I did not muck it up. You understand? I want to make sure that I did not muck it up with an M. With an M, not an F. Okay, don't get excited. That was it. That was a list of our prime numbers 1 through 50. Tomorrow we'll make a list of prime numbers 51 through 100. And that's where we have to slow down to make sure that we don't miss something. We don't miss a prime number. We don't leave out a number that is a prime number. And also to make sure that we do not end up including in our list inadvertently a number that in fact is not a prime number. Do you understand? We'll do that tomorrow, 51 through 100. Bye now.